Sharma, agriculture economist based in Chandigarh and one of the first who pointed out that these laws will result in protests across Punjab. I'm also joined by Gurcharan Das, author and someone who's been writing, claiming that this legislation is much needed. Let's get those two points of view very quickly. First to you, Gurcharan Das. You've written just now saying you want to see more reforms, not less. You actually believe these are a step in the right direction. You believe, therefore, that the government must not roll back any of these laws?
Absolutely. I think that this is the 1991 moment for India's farmer. And I do believe that the farmers' incomes will rise across the country as a result of this. And this is something that all agricultural economists have said for the last 25 to 30 years.
That's not necessarily true, Mr. Gurcharan Das. There are a number of people on the ground who are saying that these measures can only result in what they call the corporatization of agriculture, making farmers dependent on large corporates.
Well, you know, that is not true. Because, first of all, the farmer has the freedom to do what he likes. That's all it gives him, the farmer. That if he likes to go to the mandi and sell via the mandi, he can do that. He doesn't have to sell to the corporate at all. So there's nothing in the law that says that he's going to sell or he has to sell to the corporate.
The laws actually give the farmers more options. Devinder Sharma, you and others actually believe otherwise. What is it in the law that troubles you so much that you believe the government needs to relook at?
I think what the farmers are demanding, and after so many days, 8 days of the farmers' protest in New Delhi, what has come out and what should be very clear to each one of us is actually farmers are wanting that they should have an assured price, which means they should have an assured income. That's all they are asking for, primarily. Now, if that is what they are asking for, I think the way forward for that is not through corporatization of agriculture or not through these reforms, which actually open up the agriculture sector for the sake of the corporates. Now, what we actually need is assured price. Assured price comes by way of minimum support price.
What price? How do I give an assured price in the law?
Yes, minimum support price is so far confined primarily to Punjab and Haryana. You know, I want to understand, why do we think that only Punjab and Haryana farmers should get assured price, whereas the rest of the country's farmer should be left to face the vagaries of the market? For all these years, we know Shanta Kumar Committee had said that only 6% farmers get MSP, 94% farmers are dependent on markets. If markets were so good, please tell me, why is agriculture in such a serious crisis? Why are thousands of farmers dying every year? You know, that is something we need to understand. And to say that, you know, the big...
No, but what is it in this law? Devinder Sharma, what is it specifically in this law that you want to be removed or added?
In fact, it's very interesting. When we say that bring in a fourth law which assures that MSP becomes a legal right for farmers, all the corporate activists come up and say that, you know, this will be a disaster for the reforms. Because the point is, if everyone says you're going to get a higher price, please tell me, why is there objection to MSP being a legal instrument? After all, higher price to what? MSP is the only benchmark we have. If the companies are happy, if the economists are happy, if the corporate activists are happy that, you know, farmers will getting a higher price, then I think everyone should agree that, you know, MSP should be a bottom line or a legal...
You're talking like a floor price. Create some kind of a floor price within the law, yes. and that would satisfy farmers. Gurcharan Das, a final word on that. Is that a possibility, or do you believe that goes against market forces?
Well, of course it goes against market forces. This is a command economy mentality, the kind of thing that you did in the Soviet Union or in China. In a democratic country, you cannot put a price in the law. You know, it is
but
just...
But you need some
against,
protection decide, for farmers, Gurcharan Das. Surely you need some protective valve.
You can do those things. However, let's understand the problem with India's agriculture is that we have small holdings. Mm-hmm. And the farmer needs to improve the productivity of that holding. Now, this can be done by investing capital in that land. And to investing capital, etc., you can have it done by the model, the Amul model, which is to create producer, farmer producer cooperatives who can combine the land holding of 2 acres, hectares, which is what exists. So that's the beginning point. What we need is a second green revolution to make the farmers' income grow. Now, if you get stuck with the present peasant farming system, where you have to give an assured price and APMC mandi, and everything is to be given that, you know, to the farmer, oh, bechara farmer. He's not a bechara farmer. Treat him with dignity. What you're okay. asking when you say put the MSP in the thing. Of course, look, you have to understand that the reality is the government will have to keep procuring grains. They'll have to keep procuring grains because they have lakhs of ration shops to feed. Until the Food Security Bill Act goes away, you have to give the population food through the ration shop. So there will have to be a price. So forget this idea that MSP will go away, because you have to have.
But you're saying it does not need to be a legal right. What you're saying, MSP will not go, but it cannot be a legal right, because that would be anti-market in a way. Final word, 30 seconds, Devinder Sharma. Tell me, is there anything short of MSP being written into the law that you believe can be a negotiating point?
I find it very strange. You know, we are so worried about market forces, and we are at least concerned about the farmers. All these decades, farmers have suffered in India. They have been deliberately kept impoverished. And the model that Mr. Gurcharan Das is talking has failed in America and Europe. The markets there are not efficient. They are being sustained by huge subsidies. You know, if you look at today, American farmers are saddled with a bankruptcy of $425 billion. This is after 6-7 decades of market reforms in America, open markets operating in America. There are big retailers in America. They have no stock limit. There is credit. There is commodity trading in America. There is contract farming. There is no APMC. Please tell me, why are the suicide rate in America 45% higher in rural areas as compared to the urban areas? The chief economist of U.S. Department of Agriculture has gone on record saying American incomes, farm incomes since 1960s have been on a steep decline if you adjust for inflation. This is happening in America. You want to replicate a failed model from America, because economists of India can't see anything beyond America and Europe. Very sad. That's why I call them lazy economists, because they think the best way is to cut and paste from America and suggest to Indian farmers. You talked about...
Gurcharan Das, I know you're dying to step in. I'm running out of time, but I will give you 30 seconds. Okay, Devinder Sharma, you've made your point. Yes.
Give me just 30 seconds. I'm not saying that there should not be a subsidy. What I'm saying is, don't distort the market in the process. I would be very happy if we had a minimum basic income for all farmers, and give them money to buy fertilizer, to buy electricity, water, and have. But when you give free water, free electricity, fertilizer subsidy, this subsidy, then you spoil the market and you harm the farmer. So give